Howdy folks, and welcome back. So let's play Dungeon Siege. As per usual, we're jumping on in here. And since last time, I have in fact hit town and stocked us up on healing potions and mana potions and healing potions, and I sold stuff. So ideally, you know, things will not be terrible. I hope. Anyways, we are going to begin, I guess, pushing into the swamps now. I think it's this way. This place is easy to get lost in. I'd have a better time navigating it if they would let me zoom out farther than this on the map, but I believe this is the correct way to go. It looks like it. I seem to recall this area right before we entered the swamps. Anyways, yes, so ideally with proper amounts of healing potions and whatnot, we will be able to navigate just a little bit better this time. And, you know, maybe less death. Oh, and there's a plane in the background. Oh no. I'm recording this during the day because my internet has been shitting the bed for the past, I would say, 48 hours. And it finally has started performing as it's supposed to be and as I'm paying for. Normally when the internet is being bad like this and it's unusable, I don't record because it's being unusable. However, they've elected to unfuck it, and it's early in the day now, so I do have time to record. However, it is during the day now, and that means that the airport is doing things, which means you guys get to deal with background noise. I apologize. My noise culling should handle most of it, I would hope, unless we get one that's like right on top of us, which does happen on occasion, but hopefully we won't have to deal with that. We've already heard your crap. Thank you. Let us continue onward. Oh, no. He didn't drop it until he died. Thanks. Azunite artifact. There we go. But yeah, so my ISP has been garbage, as is kind of standard operating procedure everywhere except for Europe, apparently. And so, yeah, having to record a little bit later in the day. Apologies for that. It should ideally still be up on time, at least what I consider on time. And ideally, we are gonna get this resolved. I'm gonna have a tech, I think, come out to my house later this week and take a look at our actual lines, because they think that might be what's causing the issue, because it's bad. Like I said, the last 48 hours, I've been getting speeds that are less than a tenth of what I'm paying for. I pay for 100 megabit down and 15 up, and I've been getting the equivalent. I've been getting all of the down. My download's been fine, but my upstream, I've been getting like, normally I upload at a meg and a half per second, a megabyte and a half per second, which allows me to upload like an episode of this or an episode of Neverwinter Nights. It takes about an hour, which is acceptable to me. With how it's been, I've been getting about a 15th of that. I've been able to upload at about 10K a second. I've been running diagnostics, and my average upload over the last 48 hours was something like 96KB per second. And yeah, getting my Sunday morning, was it Sunday morning? My last stream is six parts. Uploading one part of that took me like 10 hours. And just no, that's not okay. So I've been raising holy hell on Twitter, which is apparently the only way to get companies to do anything anymore, is when you publicly shame them. And they've been trying to help me in what ways they can that aren't bullshit. You know, oh, use our speed test and tell us how the results are and we'll work off that. And so, you know, of course, since you're doing a speed test, it's on their network and you get your full speed. And I do get my full speed. However, you know, my service provider, that's Cox Communications, for those of you thinking about using them, they're terrible. My service provider does not provide internet service for the entire internet. So that my connection to their servers is good means jack shit. It's my connection to the rest of the internet that actually matters. And then they're like, well, you know, we don't guarantee speeds outside of our service. And it's like, basically what I told them was, so I'm going to have to resolve myself to getting speeds of less than a tenth of what I'm paying for. And they're like, oh, you know, rabble. Do our speed test again, let's see how you're looking. And so I did their speed test, and this time I throttled it on my end because I have software on my PC that I use for throttling my upload so it doesn't kill my internet. And I just throttled the upload so that I was getting my actual speeds on their service. And they're like, oh, hey, yeah, we're seeing some really bad latency here. A lot of packet loss. I'm like, yeah, so am I. And, oh, look, all of a sudden they're willing to send out a technician. And, yeah, good times. Freaking assholes. Like, there's nothing, I shouldn't say nothing. There are very few things in life that make me rage as hard as the shitty-ass internet systems of the world, where these companies basically have monopolies and they use it to just fuck everyone. It drives me nuts. And they're like, it's one of the few things where companies are just brazenly terrible because they know they've got you by the balls. Because, like, my only other opportunity is to switch over to Frontier, which is would be going to DSL as opposed to cable. And I had DSL in Indiana when I still lived there, and I'm not going to be switching back to internet service that goes out every time it rains, basically. So, yeah, they've got us by the balls, they know they have us by the balls, and so they fuck us like they have us by the balls, and it gets old, and, you know, getting kind of tired of it. And, you know, naturally, they're not gonna pay us, like, you know, cut our bill. I wish I could pay them, you know, a 15th of my bill when I'm getting a 15th of the service that they're supposed to be providing. But, you know, they've got those clauses in their contracts that say, oh, you know, we don't guarantee this speed. You get speeds up to 15 megs. I accidentally just clicked out of my window there. Which is just, it's garbage. I really wish that we could get, like, some actual fiber internet out here where I live now, but the state that I live in, for whatever reason, it's a very technologically advanced state, but our internet is garbage, and it's bad to the point that I guess there's actually there's the first one. There's actually government action trying to go on to basically force our internet service providers here to give us internet that isn't garbage, because, like, large businesses out here are actually suffering from the internet being so bad. It is insane just how broken the internet is, considering it's a facet of, you know, everyday life. But that's my rant for today. So how's the game going, guys? We're killing stuff and people are dying. Go ahead and solve that problem really quick here. Get up. So yeah, and I really don't want to start ranting, because if I get going, I'm not gonna stop, because shitty internet service is something that I can rant about pretty much without limit. Because that shit just, you want to talk about stuff that rustles my jimmies, there you go. Alright, Crowduck, what did you just grab? 53 mana, Amulet of Benediction. We will give that, well, what's her current one? 29, yeah, we'll give that to Eulora there. And Zed, you have 20, so there you go. Upgrades down the line, nice. And they are both within, like, I think 5 spell points of each other. Yeah, 64 and 67. That is acceptable to me. Alright, so I'm gonna save. Don't wanna wait too long. Okay. And onward. Let's see how this goes. Oh, hey, it's one of those guys. Ah, death breath. Alright, this is my primary target because, damn. Guys, seriously, I know you're interested in the mosquitoes, but I think this thing's probably a little bit more dangerous, as Glowern is finding out. Zed is down by the one mangler who has elected to, oh no, there's a couple of them, that has elected to just run past my melees and go straight for my back row. Heal bot, heal! Why is she not, there she goes, let's say, why is she not healing? Obnoxious woman? Oh, come on, guys, get Crowduck back up. There we go. Drink potions, guys! Yeah. Unglorin's back here. Fighting with something. I think another mangler, yeah. Alright. Back on the road. I do remember these swamps. I remember hating these swamps, so I'm not surprised that this area is going to be a source of some frustration. It's always swamps that are bad. I don't know what the deal is. It's always swamped. Speaking of, well, not really, but other fun things, I actually picked up a liquid cooling system for my PC. It should be here on Thursday, and I probably won't have time to install it until Friday. And I'm not going to have time to actually give it a good workout until Sunday, I think it's Sunday, because I've got a wedding that I'm being dragged along to on Saturday. But yeah, so I've got a liquid cooling system. It's a self-contained one, so I don't have to worry about, you know, messing with fluids and stuff, which is the primary reason that I've never looked into liquid cooling, because I don't want to deal with all of the things that I will inevitably screw up and cause it to give my system a bath. Yeah, oh my god, you stupid manglers! You're driving me nuts! So yeah, I've got that coming in, which I'm curious to see how it helps my temperatures on my system. I don't think that they're out of control now. My system runs hot, but it doesn't run hot enough that it'll actually damage any components. It need to run, I think, between 30 and 50 degrees Celsius hotter than it currently is for it to really have any risk of damaging anything. But, you know, cooler is better, and it'll quiet things down a little bit. Get to replace one of my back fans that rattles a little bit with the radiator combo from this thing, and I'm also going to be able to install a, what is that, 240mm side fan that I've been wanting to install for, I don't know, 6 months. Seriously, guys, just walk faster than her. There, Jesus. Man, leave it to Dungeon Siege to make an enemy slowly shambling away from you a legitimate combat strategy. Freaking ridiculous. Ugh, that is exactly what I was trying to prevent happening by focusing on those stupid casters, but apparently that did not work. Alright, so my entire back row is dead or unconscious. Come on, guys. For God's sake. Just focus fire. I thought these things unsummoned once the casters died, but apparently they do not. That kind of chaps my ass a little bit. Hey, Krug's back up. Krug, get in on the fight! Come on now. I'm a lazy ass. Okay. There we go. These things really aren't much of a threat. Okay, there we go. Alright, let's get... Oh man, that both of my casters dies, that's gonna make freaking rezzing them a pain in the ass. Alright. Start with you, Laura. Get up. Come over here. Loot your stuff. Okay, that's her stuff, I think. Yes. Okay, now let's do Zed. Zed the Dead. Zed, pick up all your stuff. No, don't be running around like a jackass. Alright, there we go. Okay, so that's another fight and another couple scrolls of resurrection down. That's... we're getting low, and that worries me. Although I was supposed to see it theoretically, I could have only used one and just had, I want to say Zed res somebody, although I think she might have, yeah, she has revived too. So I should probably keep that in mind, that my back row actually can raise the dead. But, yeah. So, new cooling, I'm excited about that. I'm hopeful that it's, you know, a marked increase. It's crazy to me that, you know, I've got this massive-ass heatsink on my CPU now, and I'm going to be installing this tiny little liquid cooling system, and it's going to cool this thing so much better. I understand, like, the physics of how it works, because, you know, the heat transfers to the liquid goes to radiator sitting on a fan, and the fan cools the radiator, which transfers the liquid back, which is cooled now, and, you know, it's just a constant closed circuit like that. But it's just, it blows my mind that that works. It's just so cool. No, you shitlord, leave my back row alone. Like, seriously. It was sitting there meleeing my front row, and then all of a sudden, it elects that it wants to go back and start trying to maim my archer. Because raisins. Come on, guys. Just murder everything. Hey, level 26 melee. If only weapons requirements were based on your skill instead of your stats. You son of a bitch. No, kill it. Oh my god. Wrong button. That's what I want. Medium crossbow, edge staff, swamp club. That stuff can just stay. I think I'm gonna stick to the point now where I'm just going to be picking up magic items simply because inventory space is at a premium now. And it looks like we have what we were looking for. Two casters that want to die. Leave my archers alone, please. I'm gonna kick your... Ooh. Boiled leather greaves. I think that's the, like, semi-cursed ones right there. What we got? Minus 12 mana, plus 1 melee, plus 15 health. That is an upgrade for Gjorn, assuming he's strong enough to use them, which he is. Here you go, Gjorn. Nice, get rid of these. We made longsword, which is, wow, 57 to 85. Holy crap. Plus one ranged skill, though. That's useful. All right, so 26. I think Gjorn can actually use this. Yes, that is also an upgrade. And this is 40 to 56. Krug! Yes. Wow, look at that. Upgrades all the way down, except for Glorn, who's only got a strength of 20. Because he's terrible. That pleases me. Our entire front row, almost, just got melee upgrades. I'm gonna save again. This looks a little ominous. You know, I'm slightly worried at, you know, graves and stuff, because graves portend undead, not to mention the weeping angels. Alright. So this is what we're looking for. What do we got? Wretched zombie. And a bronze gargoyle. And a grave crawler, because crawling corpses are so in right now. Krug's taking some punishment. But, quest has been updated. Are we done now? Place the holy icon on the altar. Alright, so we'll do that in just a moment. Obviously sing right there. Oh, okay, things are kind of going, I wouldn't say tits up, but they're going badly. Let's have Gjorn go ahead and do that now, see if that does anything. No. Alright, I was hoping that would kind of, you know, stymie the flow of undead that are currently, you know, forcing their way in here. You come down here. Mule, you apparently are terrible enough that your existence does not allow me to see through the roofs of buildings. Oh, the zombies are going for the mule. That's a problem. That is a problem. The mule is down. The mule is down. What do we do when the mule is down? We pray that everything doesn't focus on the mule because I don't want to have to res the fucking thing. Jesus. Yeah, I'm not surprised. I was figuring something was going to happen. I didn't think they were going to go for the mule, though. Why would you go for an innocent mule? It did nothing wrong. It just does what mules do. It followed. Yeah, look at this. This is going to be a fight right here. Let's resolve this. Zombies. Krug. I tried to get him to drink. I say, but he's. I thought he was out of potions there for a second, but he is not. Okay. Switch to his mace because I don't know why it does that sometime where it's like, hey, guess what? I equipped the weapon I was already equipped with, guys. It's awesome. Mana. I'm gonna actually have my healers heal the mule. There we go. Didn't mean to drink that mana potion. Should I want to come back in here for a second and see? Yeah, as I say, I thought I saw some chests in here. That one's worthless. This one a little less so. Some studded leather boots. What'd you get? 15 armor. Yes. There you go. System works. Okay, let's get out of here. Poke around a little bit. More zombies. Krug just increased in dex and intelligence, though. You go, Krug. Wow, these things actually have a lot of hit points. 2,000 health. That is a little absurd. Devon just increased in strength again. Nice. Zombie attempting to attack Zed there. I noticed. I saw it ambling in his direction. 22,000 gold. All right. Oh god, gargoyles. These things only got like 100 hit points and change. It's a little bit more manageable, however they hit pretty hard. As Krug is finding out, so we're going to prioritize them over the zombie hordes. Goo walkers. All right, there we go. Casters, I want you guys to come down over here. Melees, you just keep doing what you're doing. Mule! You looking at, you are fucking kidding me. Like, this game, I swear, I'm pissed. Like, this game is now just, it is literally just trying to fuck me, and it's getting old. Res him. Do that. Drink a mana potion. Zed, I'm gonna have to micromanage you here for a second, because once you get up... See, there he goes, as I say. Drink potion. Drink potion! Zed, you don't actually have potions. Instead, you are electing to enter melee combat. Oh my friggin' god, would you assholes kill the zombies? Zed's like, I'm effective, guys. I love it. You know, I tell these guys to do something, and as soon as I go to move Zed, they all elect to instead do their own thing. And Zed wants to get in. All right, you know, whatever. We're gonna see how this pans out. Melees, melee, Zed, die. Oh my god. The party control in this game. It's maddening. It's maddening! You'd figure if they were gonna have me controlling a small army, they'd at least make it control halfway decently. But they don't. Alright, Zed, I know you have Resurrect. Alright, so Resurrect her stupid ass. All your crap. Healing. Ugh. That was more difficult than it needed to be. Not in any least part because that stupid Hydra thing elected that it was going to pop up over there. Whew. Come on, guys. Just open the gate. That's what I want you to do. It's actually surprisingly hard to target things in this sometimes. Hey, Glowern leveled to 15 in melee. Every time he levels, it's just surprising to me how far behind everyone else he is. But I can't get rid of him because, you know, stereotypes. Okay. Let's open this crap. See if we can maybe kill this group of zombies over here. Holy lord. Hey, Krug seed. Look at that, Krug. We didn't get that much before. Well, now we got Krug a little ways before we got Glowern, I suppose. Where's the witch at? Because I think... So if we aggro her again, she's just gonna summon another one of those things. Just like that. Oh look, two more! Slowly shambling away as Zed is getting the crap beaten out of him in the back row, along with Eulora, because we have to chase these things down or they infinitely summon enemies! Look at that, Zed's dead. Zed's dead, baby. res him. Or go unconscious. Oh, there we go. Back rows down again. What a twist. Like, they're actually becoming now, they're becoming more of a liability than anything. Because they just cannot stay alive for any meaningful amount of time in combat. Look at them. There we go. What do we have here? Oh, wow. Glorn just died. That actually kind of surprised me. That's probably these things. I assume he got kind of, basically in the way of some projectiles. But yeah, it's getting to the point now where my back row is becoming something of a liability because of the way enemies just kind of completely ignore my front row to go for them. And we are running out of res scrolls. I mean, I'm going to use one and I'm going to res Zed with it because his raises are cheaper than Eulora's. But it's kind of bullshit that those things, when they summon stuff, it doesn't disappear because that means that I have to prioritize them or they'll just, you know, spam their summons. Because enemies in this have infinite spell points. And basically, oh Jesus Christ, I don't even know whose gear is whose. This is the downside and why you should never have players drop all of their equipment when they die in your games. Bad game developers. Well, I shouldn't say never have them drop their gear. Never drop their, having them drop their gear like this in your games. Because seriously, like put it in a gravestone or something. Give me a corpse to loot. I have no problem with corpse runs. This, however, is a load of bullshit. All right, heal, heal, drink mana, drink heals. Glorn, I hate you a little bit right now. I think this is your armor. I think this is your helm. That's yours, that's yours, this is yours. So these are his upgrades. That's the mule. Oh god, he picked up all of the, yeah. Okay. All right, that looks, I guess, about right. As right as it's gonna get, and he's actually in somewhat dire need of healing potions, so I'll go ahead and give him a handful of them here. Okay, so that's that, and we are at 28 minutes, so I do think I'm gonna call it, because I honestly don't know where to go, truth be told. So, I'm not gonna look it up, but I would like to have some, you know, a decent chunk of time where we can kind of fan out a little bit and explore, because, well, at least we have a bridge here, and there's some gold laying around, but I'm really not too interested in it, because we've got, what, like, yeah, I was gonna say, like, 200,000 gold pieces now, I'm comfortable with our current wealth. But I'm gonna call it here. So, as per usual, folks, thank you for watching. I hope you had a good time, even though I raged about things basically the entire episode. I will catch you all next time, where in Swamp Stuff will continue. Until then.